here in the middle. And we camped just over here. That's where we lived for like, I don't know, 4 months or something. But now they got a camp kitchen. To get our washing done for work.
Every weekend.
So there's the silos there. And we would live here. And then the pub is just across the road. Just over there. We've come into a surf spot. We normally check this spot out every time we're heading across the WA. And we're crossing this car and wind down the window and he goes, "I know you guys. The last time I saw you, we were sitting at the top of Mitchell Falls." So that was all the way in Northern Territory. So that would have been about 4 years ago we've seen this guy. His name's Ian. He's such a lovely dude. We chatted to him for ages last time we met him. So we just like went down the window, had a chat to him, and yeah, we just couldn't believe it. It's pretty much opposite ends of Australia. And yeah, now we met him in South Australia, so that was pretty cool. Wax her up, boy. I'm gonna take the wax off mine. It's pretty fruity. Look at that, that's gross. Melted up the stairs. Surf's up this morning. So he's getting tired arms from waxing my boy. It's offshore, so it should be pretty fun. Just gonna get out there nice and early. Catch a few waves, hopefully, before the crowd gets into it.
Hello.
You look exhausted, mate.
Me so hungry.
Got these bad boys cooking up. Gotta try that. How 10 out of 10 are you happy? Serve some pancakes. Occasions is that when you cross the borders in Australia, to remember to cook up your food before you go across, especially like WA, South Australia, going in between there, and we've got caught out a few times, and you have to give all your fruit and veg to the people at the borders. So right now I'm just cooking up whatever we had left over, which wasn't much because we planned it that way. A bit of onion and garlic and some pine nuts as well, and I've just sauteed it in the sesame oil and whatever I've got left over. I've got a few sweet potatoes and normal potatoes. We're just gonna have chips on the side and then our veggies that were left. I don't know, let's see how it works. It might turn out all right and taste good. So oh yeah, and a little bit of corn on the side. That's pretty sweet. So you can go online and check what foods you can and can't take in between the borders. Normally we just get rid of it all, so then we don't have to worry about it. And by get rid of it, I mean cook it up or eat it. I just chucked in a bit of veggie stock and some couscous. Make us feel a bit fuller. Alright, skinny. You've had your surf, you're hungry.
Yes.
Now you're gonna taste the weird ass couscous mixture. Couscous mixture.
Oh, good.
Couscous mixture.
Yes, yum.
Not too bad for a random ass mix together.
Like genius, man.
Oh. Good tucker. The Nullabor is a spectacular adventure to go on, if you know how to do it right. My suggestion is to slow down, take some of the dirt tracks, get curious, because you never know what you might stumble upon. Join us next time as we continue to explore Australia's longest straight road. We take some back roads, explore some caves, and generally just get up to a bit of mischief. And if you haven't done so already, hit the like, subscribe, and notification buttons for more.